introduce you to our today's guest speaker, Dr. Shikha Sharma, IRS Income Tax. It's my pleasure to introduce this great personality on behalf of our prestigious institute, Sri Aurobindo College of Commerce and Management, Ludhiana. So Dr. Shikha Sharma has cleared twice the civil service exam conducted by UPSC and has secured first rank in HPAS in 2014. Her academic qualification, she has done BDS from Himachal Pradesh Government Dental College. She has also done MA in Public Administration and History. Also, she has cleared various exams like SGIPO, Administrative Officer in ICAR. In today's lecture, she will be sharing her views on how to prepare for civil services. I request all for your kind cooperation throughout this lecture. And I would request our Honorable Principal, Dr. Ajay Sharma, to say a few words to commence this session.
Respectable Shikha Sharma, ma'am, IRS, it is indeed a privilege for all of us that to have the speaker of your eminence here. I am thankful to Sankalp Academy also for organizing the theme to our students. Sri Aurobindo College of Commerce and Management, Ludhiana, has the courses in the area of BCom and BBA, and it is one of the most sought after college in this area. And the students are doing apart from their own incubation and preparation from the CAT MAT. There are a few students who are also interested in the competitive examination, and I hope that today's session will be certainly help them a lot in preparing for their future, and hopefully they will be taking a lot of help from Madam Shikha Sharma, because you know personal experiences are much better than anything else. So you should have an interactive session, and students should be in a position to clear their doubts. Once again, I welcome the key speaker, Madam Shikha Sharma, to our college. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Shikha Sharma. I'm presently working as Assistant Commissioner Income Tax in Delhi. I am here to share my experiences and simultaneously acquaint you with the nuances of civil services examination preparation. First of all, I want to discuss, I want to convey some very beautiful message before you start your preparation, or before I convey my message to all of you. My dear friends, at the very onset, I'm assuming that you all are having embarked on this journey with a very determined frame of mind. I raise this point because the first thing that is most fundamental aspect about this exam is there is no turning back from
here. Hello, ma'am. Understand what you are saying. मैम आपकी वॉइस बहुत ज़्यादा इको कर रही है. हेलो Okay, so ma'am will be with us in a while. The voice was getting very echoed, so she'll be joining again with us. So sorry for the glitch, but she'll be joining in a minute again.
Okay, so should I start? Okay.
Okay, thank you for being a patient audience. Now our guest is back with us, and now I would request the ma'am to enlighten us with her words of wisdom.
Hi everyone, I'm very sorry for this disturbance. Actually there was an internet issue, so I have logged it into other computer. So I'll start today's session. I am Dr. Shikha Sharma. Presently, I am working in Delhi. I am working as an IRS officer, and I am serving as Assistant Commissioner Income Tax Delhi. Last year, I was looking for South Delhi, and these days, I am working in faceless assessment in income tax. So, my dear friends, I would like all of you to prepare for this exam, because first of all, I want to instill confidence in all of you that to clear this exam, is though it is a difficult exam of this world, but after you clear this exam, it is a beautiful journey. And I want to share my experiences afterwards, because I belong to a middle family and I was the first one to serve in government sector, and that too at the officer level post. So, you know, I have given lot to my family, to my relatives, because they're very happy. The things which I can do here at this stage of life, I mean, it is incredible. I see. I have seen my father struggling for small things, but when I see myself, for my family, it is now very easy to get into anything. Like every work is done. So I want to say that start your preparation with courage, with determination. Always look around your family and look toward the betterment of the society also. Because at these posts, we can contribute a lot towards society also. Because people look at you, look up to you, and they expect from you. And you feel really happy when you can help them. Because I want to share that during the time of lockdown, a lot of people approached us because they just wanted the passes to travel to their home cities. And then they wanted to meet their families, sometimes in the emergency situations. So I helped a lot. So it has given me immense pleasure. So now I'll... my session for today is how to prepare for civil services examination. And before that, I want to share a few lines with you. My dear friends, at the very onset, I'm assuming that you all have embarked on this journey with a very determined frame of mind. I raise this point because the first thing that is most fundamental aspect about this exam is there is no turning back from here. My dear friends, mark these words. There is no turning back from here now. If you start your preparation with full determination, with full encouragement, either you sail through or you sink. But my dear friends, it should be very clear in your head that you are choosing this journey to break the ice. And we have always heard that if you don't clear exam also, don't be disheartened. Because knowledge never goes waste. You have seen me also. I have given my exam. I want to give my example. I have written one book about Himachal Pradesh Competitive Examination, General Studies. Because I have, although it was the chance that I might have not cleared the exam, but still the knowledge which I have accumulated, that was priceless. And that is paying me till that time also. So don't expect results always, but do your studies with full determination without thinking about result and give your 100%. And before sharing the strategy about this exam, I want to convey very important message. I have read one book from Yuval Noah Harari few days back. In that book, it was written that the problem of this time is not about the availability of the information. The problem of this time is overloading of information. So you should know what to study and what not to study, because there is a lot of information in the market about the examination. There are a lot of books, but you should choose wisely what you have to read, what you not.
because civil service examination is always a smart preparation. It needs smart preparation. It needs smart minds. It does not need hardworking, padhaku people. It needs smart people. Jinko pata ho ki kaun si books choose karni hai, exam mein kya likhna hai. My dear friends, when you write mains, you know, you get question which you have to answer in 200 words, in 300 words. So there is a words limit also. So they give marks. If you overwrite, they don't give you marks. So what is that reflecting? That is reflecting that you have to write precise. You should be clear in your head. You know what to write there. It's not like you have to write vaguely what you know. No, it is called smart preparation. If you have to define anything in 50 words, what does that mean? That you know, you should be clear in your heart. So this exam is all about smart preparation, what I think. And I think most of the people who have cleared exam, they think like this only, right? So herein, I'll discussing various facets of preparation in terms of relevant questions. In this session, I have prepared, I'll tell the strategy question-wise. I have prepared questions and that will answer you. It is possible that you have those questions in your mind. So I have prepared question and I'll answer those questions. These questions are very much pertinent as far as the extent and clarity of examination is concerned. So my dear friend, first question always arises in our head that what is the right time to begin the preparation for civil services? And when I was doing my graduation, I always used to think, ki exam ki tayari kab karun? PG kar leti hu, uske baad tayari karti hu. Dekho, my friends, the answer to this question is, there is no such thing as right time. Here, I want to give example of two persons who are very well known in civil services. First is Tina Dabi. Tina Dabi has started her preparation during the graduation time, right? And she has cracked her exam in the very first attempt because she was preparing for the exam since beginning. So she was well prepared and she has cleared the exam. Second example I want to give is Anu Kumari. She is from Haryana and I think she was the second rank holder in civil service examination 2017. She has started her preparation when only two attempts were left with her. But she has cleared civil services examination in the first attempt only. Why? Because her strategy was right. Time is not important. The strategy is important. And my dear friends, it's a long cycle. It takes 1 year to give exam. It's not like preparation. Preparation time is different. But to give exam is a cycle. It is like 1 year cycle. And there are three steps in clearing the exams. First is prelim examination. Second is mains examination. And third is interview. So all these three stages are very important because if you failed in one step, the cycle is rolled over. You have to give exam again. So it's like you need perseverance. You need determination, not to study, but to give exam also. You have to be focused. You have to be positive minded always. Only then you can clear this exam, right? So there is no right time to start the preparation. It's on your will. It depends upon your circumstances. It depends on the situation where you are living. There are family circumstances also. So you should be determined. You should be focused. You should know what to study and then start your preparation. It's very easy. I'll say it's not very difficult to crack this exam. It's only the attitude which matters. Right. So, my dear friends, when you decided categorically or prudently to prepare for examination, you should start it right away. Right. So, my dear friends, as this session is only for 1 hour today, I'll discuss the strategy for preliminary examination and that too, general studies paper one, very widely I'll discuss. Right. Prelim examination is very important step to give the exam. Because this is the determining step that you will go on. And it is, you know, prelim is the toughest stage as far as I think in this exam. Why? Because 10 lakh people, they fill the exams. They fill the paper. They fill the civil services examination paper. And then around 5 to 6 lakh people appear. And last year, only 10,000 people cleared the prelims. So my dear friend, this is very crucial stage. And you should be very, 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 you know, very smart to attempt the prelim examination. Because preliminary examination has two parts, general studies paper one and general studies paper two. General studies paper one contains 100 questions and general studies paper two contains 80 questions. General study paper two is a qualifying examination. Almost you need 27 questions right to qualify this exam, then you can sail through general studies paper two. But my dear friends, don't take general studies paper two very lightly, because that also need hard work. Because I have seen a lot of people, they have cleared general studies paper one, but they got failed in general studies paper two because they took it very lightly. Like they say, it is a qualifying examination. Don't take this lightly. I'll tell you further how to approach general studies paper two. In the same way, I want to discuss here about mains ka qualifying examination, that is English and Hindi. Those exams also people take very lightly, that English Hindi to hum shuru se padhte hain and we will clear that, but it's not like that. I have seen people failing in those exams also. Because friends, this is the toughest exam of this world. It is not very easy and it is very unpredictable. You just cannot predict ki you know this thing, you know that thing. In this exam, you cannot be like overconfident. Never. So you have to be always be focused. Chahe wo one mark ka hi question ho, you should be very careful, because competition here in this exam is very tough. In interviews also, you should not be very overconfident that you know the answer. You just cannot say ki aapne bahut acha interview diya hai, to you will get very good marks. No. While answering the interview's question also, you have to be very much humble. Because I want to share my experiences about interview, about my last interview when I got selected in IRIS IT. My board was Arvind Subramanyam. And I have given very good interview. I was very sure about that I have given. And I'm always very good in interview also. Because I still remember, I cleared State Bank probationary officer exam. And I got 47 marks out of 50. So it was quite good. And I want to tell this also, I have cleared UPSC examination twice. For the first time, I got 492 rank and I got Indian Audit and Account Services. And that time, my board was for interview, Divan sir. He gave me 185 marks. And that time, my interview was not very good. I was not that much satisfied. But second time, when I gave interview, when I got selected in IRIS IT, I got the board of Arvind Subramanyam, and it was unbelievable that I just got 150 marks in interview. And because of that difference only, I did not get the rank what I wanted. So my dear friends, you just cannot be overconfident in this exam. You have to be humble. You have to be considerate at all the stages. This is my message to all of you. Start your preparation with hard work, smart preparation, but don't get overconfident never in this exam. While writing prelims also, you will see the paper, aap bologe mujhe to ye bhi aata hai and I'll clear the exam. No. If you think that these questions are easy, just be humble. Read other questions also and then attempt, because the main hassle to clear this exam is overconfidence, which I think, right? So my dear friends, now I'll be widely discussing general studies paper one with you, and that too about prelims first, right? My dear friends, prelim examination paper one, it contains 7 sections broadly. And the syllabus about this exam, you can directly download from UPSC website, right? I have also downloaded it from UPSC website syllabus, which I will discuss with you. And I'll share books also. So keep a pen and copy with you to write the name of books. And I will suggest, you can trust me, if you read these books, your preparation, your 60% or 70% preparation would be done. If you read these books line by line and properly, right? So paper one contains 7 sections broadly. First, current events of national and international importance. Second subpart of General Studies paper one is history of India and Indian national movement. Third part of this paper is Indian and world geography. And that too is divided into physical, social, economic geography of India and world, right? And the fourth part of this paper is Indian polity and governance. That includes Constitution of India, political system, Panchayati Raj system, public policies of India, constitutional bodies of India, and so on, right? And the next part of this session, next part of this paper is economic and social development. That includes sustainable development, poverty, inclusion, demography, social sector, and so on. And the next part is general issues on environmental ecology, biodiversity, and climate change. And the last part is general science. My dear friends, these are the broad topics you read in the notification while going through, preparing for civil services. But if you have copy and pen, write another subtopic also, which is very important, which is not explicitly described in the syllabus, but that constitutes an important part because you get questions in prelims about this part also. And that part is art, architecture and culture of India. You will see in prelim examination that around 10 questions will come from this part. And people, they assume that, UPSC people assume that art, architecture and culture is a part of history. And of course, that is a part of history. But nowadays, you need a smart study. So you should know that this is a separate subject. While preparing, you should know that this is a separate subject. So you have to prepare very much in for this subject also, for this part also, right? Now, my dear friends, keep a copy and pen with you. I'll be telling the books and the sub parts of the topics. The first part I'll discuss is History of India and Indian National Movement. So, history includes three parts: ancient history, medieval history, and modern India. My dear friends, you should keep this in mind that you have to go to market today and you have to buy NCERTs of history, geography, environment, general sciences from class 6 to class 12, because they are very important. And what you have to do, for initial 2 months, you have to read NCERTs only, 6 to 12, for these subjects, right? And make notes about the topics you have studied in NCERT, and then always keep revising those notes, because later on in your preparation, you will never get time to read NCERTs again and again. So if you make notes in the initial stage only, you will revise those notes only, and that will be very helpful. NCERTs are very helpful in this examination. Either it is about prelims or about mains. They are very important part of our preparation, right? So what you have to do today, you have to go to market, buy NCERTs from 6 to 12 about history, geography, polity, and economics also, and environmental and ecology also, right? Now, for ancient and medieval history, you have to read, this is very, very, very good book, which I will suggest. It is Ancient and Medieval India by Poonam Dalal Dahiya. She is Deputy Superintendent of Police in Haryana. And presently, and afterwards, she was working in IRS only. But now she has reverted back to DYSP Haryana. So, but this book is very good. This will help you a lot. After reading NCERT, if you read this book, you can connect all the topics. And that will, you know, that will help you always. Right. And for modern India, modern history.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, can you please repeat the book of Ancient and Medieval History?
Yeah, it is Ancient and Medieval India by Poonam Dalal Dahiya. Right. Can I continue now?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay. Now I am telling you the book about modern history and Indian National Movement. For that, first you have to read NCERT. Then only you will connect with all the events of the modern times. And second book, you have to read Spectrum, most important book about modern history and Indian National Movement, Spectrum. And the third book, which is must read, is History of Modern India by Bipin Chandra. I hope everyone has written the name of book. I'll repeat once. For ancient and medieval India, go to book by Poonam Dalal Dahiya. And for modern history and Indian national movement, read Spectrum. And then History of Modern India by Bipin Chandra. Now, the next subtopic of General Studies Paper 1 is quality. Quality is very, very, very important, either while preparing for interview, for writing pre, for writing mains. And the one and foremost, and the one and very important book is M. Lakshmi Kant. This is the, you know, you can say kunji to know the concepts of Indian polity. It is very, very, very good book. No one can recommend any other book besides this. M. Lakshmi Kant, and buy a new edition of this book, right? M. Lakshmi Kant. Then, for polity, I'll always suggest M. Lakshmi Kant, because bahut sare log suggest karte hain D.D. Basu, but I will say, go for this book. This will clear your concept. This will help you writing exam, and this will help you in prelims as well as mains, right? Now, the third topic I'll discuss is geography. Hello? Geography. Geography, as I have discussed, geography contains many subparts like human geography, physical geography, Indian geography, and then world geography. So geography mein the important part is maps, atlas. Maps, you should always buy a good atlas. And atlas, which I would recommend, either you go for Orient map, atlas, sorry, and another one is Black Swan. It's your choice which one you like. I personally like Black Swan a lot, right? And for maps, you have to do one more thing. By K. Siddhartha. The name of the book is Geography Through Maps, K. Siddhartha. It is a wonderful book. It will help you. If you open this K. Siddhartha and atlas together, you can locate the rivers which K. M. Siddhartha is describing. You can locate the mountains which K. M. Siddhartha is describing in his book. You can locate peaks, which is very important question for prelims. Okay? You can locate those things in the atlas and map. So keep these two books always together to understand the maps. So you have to buy Orient or Black Swan map. And second book, which you have to buy only for understanding of map, is K. M. Siddhartha. That is, the name of the book is Geography Through Maps, K. M. Siddhartha. Right. Now, I'll come for another books about geography. Right. It is Go Chin Leong, G-O-C-H-E-N-L-E-O-N-G. This book covers physical and human geography. And this is wonderful book for prelims as well as mains. Go Chi Leong, right? And my dear friends, for other things like to understand the Indian and world geography broadly, you have to go through Majid Hussain once, right? So you will get to know about the subject geography, what you have to read, what is important, because that will Majid Hussain will describe about the origin of earth crust, origin of universe, and about many other things also, about soils, climate, because that is very important. That is very important for geography, because you will get questions from these exams only, from these subjects only, right? And my dear friends, I always emphasized NCERTs, 6th to 12th. But for geography, 11th class ki NCERT is the most important book. 11th class ka NCERT is the most important book, because I still remember hum mains ka exam 11th class ki NCERT se likha karte the, because it is unparalleled. Jo cheeze aapko 11th class ki NCERT mein milengi, you will never get those things in any other book. So always keep this book handy with you while preparing for exam. Right? So I'll move further to economy. economy mein, as I have always said, go through NCERTs from 6th to 12th. 11th and 12th class ki economy is the important book, and it will help you to understand the basic concepts of economy, like GDP, aap acche se samajh sakte hai economy se, right? And the other economy ke liye, what I say, and after my long experience, I can say that don't buy any other book for economy, but go through Mrunal. Mrunal ka ek website chalta hai. You can search online and you have to take compiled notes from Mrunal. That will help to understand the concept, and that will clear of many questions of exam. Mrunal ka ek concise jo hai, ye har week nikalta hai. So you have to go to Mrunal ka website and get the economy notes from there. And I don't think you have to read any other book for economy. राइट एंड इकोनॉमी का बहुत सारा पार्ट आपका रोज जो डेली न्यूज़पेपर्स होते हैं यू विल गेट आंसर्स फ्रॉम दोज पेपर्स आल्सो आई विल डिस्कस लेटर ऑन हाउ टू रीड न्यूज़पेपर आल्सो राइट सो नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज एनवायरमेंटल इकोलॉजी फर्स्ट यू हैव टू रीड एनसीईआरटीज एंड देन देयर इज अ बुक फ्रॉम शंकर आईएएस अबाउट एनवायरमेंटल इकोलॉजी लास्ट सिक्स ईयर्स से मैं यही देखती हूँ कि लोग इसी बुक को पढ़ के ये वाला टॉपिक अपना प्रिपेयर करते हैं बिकॉज दिस बुक इज अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव बुक एंड इट कवर्स ऑल द टॉपिक्स ऑल द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर आस्क्ड इन सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन सो फॉर एनवायरमेंटल इकोलॉजी यू हैव टू गो थ्रू बुक बाय शंकर आईएएस एंड दैट इज वेरी गुड बुक एंड वन थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू कन्वे टू ऑल ऑफ यू दैट इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फ्रॉम वेरी फार ऑल्सो लाइक लुधियाना मैं भी शिमला में प्रिपेयर करती थी तो दैट टाइम तो दिस फैसिलिटी वॉज नॉट अवेलेबल अभी आप नेट पे सर्च कर लीजिए राजेंद्र नगर में बुक शॉप मुखर्जी नगर में बुक शॉप एंड देन यू कैन ऑर्डर बुक डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम बुक शॉप ऑल्सो यू गिव योर एड्रेस टू देम ऑन फोन एंड यू विल गेट नंबर ऑन फोन ऑल्सो एंड आप उनको अपना मैसेज एड्रेस कर दीजिए एंड दे विल सेंड बुक्स ऑल्सो एट होम ऑल्सो हमारे टाइम पे तो इतना फैसिलिटी नहीं था बट नाउ दे डू दिस ऑल्सो राइट सो यू कैन ऑर्डर बुक today also and otherwise on Amazon you can get most of the books right then the next topic is general science is also very important because we get around 5 to 10 questions in civil services pre-examination from general sciences so you have to read NCERTs 6th to 10th class and the other important book about general sciences it is a book about the name of the book is science and technology It is published by Tata McGraw-Hill and the author is Ravi Agrahari. Ravi Agrahari, Science and Technology by Tata McGraw-Hill. Right, friends? And general science, mein, you will get questions in mains also. So if you read this book na, properly, Tata McGraw-Hill, Science and Technology by Ravi Agrahari, So all your concepts will be cleared and you can write pre and mains from this book only. And although NCERTs, they are the basic books, right? And then the next topic I'll move on is art, architecture and culture. As I've already told that UPSC people think that it is a part of history and they don't mention this subject explicitly, but this is an important part. You have to follow one and the foremost book to understand this part is a book by Nitin Singhania and this book is also published by Tata McGraw-Hill so this book you have to refer and it is a mandatory book right and then the next topic is current affairs is very important part because as far as I think this will if you are updated in current affairs now then it will boost your confidence also to speak anything to write any exam to talk to anyone and while giving interview also it is very 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 important right so current affairs ko update karne ke liye apne aap ko ek acha feel karane ke liye current affairs aapko padhne hi padhne hain aur uske liye aapko do important newspapers unme se aap koi bhi choose kar sakte hain you can choose any one of them First is Hindu and second is Indian Express, right? I myself always have read the Hindu because and in the Hindu also you have to read editorial page and then you have to rethink, analyze what is said and what the writer of the article wants to convey the message, because it is very important. If you try to find out the message in those articles, that will increase your ability to for comprehension also. That would be very helpful in general studies paper too. That would help you to analyze the situations, analyze the current affairs, and that would help you in mains. So newspapers, initially when you start reading newspaper like the Hindu, it easily takes 3 to 3.5 hours, because for me it took 3.5 hours also. I have devoted for newspaper. So you have to give that much time in the initial phases, right? And then it tapers down. When you keep reading, then you know what to read, what not to read. Later on, it tapers down, but initially you have to invest this much time. And my dear friends, for current affairs, along with newspaper, like you can go for Hindu or the Indian Express, you should supplement your preparation about current affairs with one magazine. And the name of magazines I would suggest is Epic by Forum IS. These magazines you will get online also from Forum IS website, right? The name of the magazine is Epic, right? And the second magazine you can go, you can choose is from Vision IS. They also release monthly magazine, and it is also a good version, and it tells everything about current affairs which you need in examination, right? But stick to only one paper and stick to only one magazine, whichever you like, right? So newspaper reading is very important part, and you have to create habit. You have to make this habit to read newspaper daily. And for me, I want to share one thing with all of you, that when we used to give exam, then for 15, 20 days, we are very busy always, right? And then there is no time while writing exam ki roz aake newspaper padhe and roz apne aapko update kare. So you know what I used to do? I used to pile up 15 papers, 20 papers, 30 papers, and if they are pending also, I'll keep them with myself. And then I used to read them in 1 week, like for 1 week, 3 days, jitna bhi time. But I have never skipped any newspaper. Till this time also, I read the Hindu daily. And I started my preparation in the year 2010. From that time till this date, I read the Hindu daily. Because that I told you in the initial stage that there is no turning back. Although I'm not giving any exam, but there's no turning back. I am upgrading myself. Today I'm speaking in front of you. That is also a part of preparation, right? Preparation is not stick only to give exam. Preparation is always. I wrote book about Himachal Pradesh competitive examinations. And that is also a continuous journey. So that was my meaning, that it is no turning back. And my dear friends, किसी भी चीज को प्रिपेयर करना और उसके रिजल्ट उसी तरह से मिल जाना इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज वी डोंट नो कि उसमें क्या हिडन फैक्टर है, राइट? सो कीप अ पॉजिटिव फ्रेम ऑफ माइंड इन यू. लाइक व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड प्रिपरेशन, आई नेवर थॉट कि मैं एग्जाम क्लियर करूं. आई वॉज एंजॉइंग कि मुझे इतना पता लग रहा है चीजों का, बिकॉज बिफोर दैट आई वॉज वेरी पुअर इन जनरल स्टडीज. यू विल नॉट बिलीव, टिल ग्रेजुएशन आई डिड नॉट इवन नो हु इज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ द कंट्री. कैन यू इमेजिन दिस? This was the level of my preparation till graduation. But afterwards, I put 1 year whole dedicated I was for preparation. And I used to sit from 6 to 12 in the night. And I upgraded myself with all the general studies in 1 year only. And within 1 year, I have cleared 2 prelims of state services. And I have given 1 mains also. I have cleared Rajasthan Civil Services examination. Within 1 year only, I have upgraded myself so much that I have cleared 2 prelims and I have written 1 mains of Rajasthan also, right? And my dear friends, about General Studies Paper 2, right? General Studies Paper 2 contains subparts like comprehension, interpersonal skills, including communication skills, logical reasoning and analytical ability. Next is decision-making and problem-solving. And then general mental ability. And the last part of this is basic numeracy, right? So in short, I will say general studies paper 2, main aapko do cheezon ka dhyan rakhta hai. First is your maths, basic maths you should know. And what to do to improve your basic maths? You have to buy R.S. Agarwal, right? R.S. Agarwal quantitative aptitude karke kitab aata hai. You have to buy that and start solving maths ke questions from that, because they are very basic questions and they will help helpful in general studies paper 2. And for other things like comprehension, general mental ability, you have to buy R.S. Agarwal also. ठीक है, R.S. Agarwal आपको दोनों पार्ट उसके खरीदने हैं, क्वांटिटेटिव एप्टीट्यूड एंड फॉर जनरल रीजनिंग ऑल्सो, राइट? एंड स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग दोज क्वेश्चंस एंड यू विल इजिली अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चंस एंड व्हेन यू ट्राई टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस यू विल इजिली गेट द फॉर्मूलाज ऑल्सो, राइट? एंड माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, बिसाइड्स दिस आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर दैट यू हैव टू बाय old question papers of general studies, civil services, paper 1 as well as paper 2 simultaneously while preparing for exam. Because I told you, it's a smart preparation. So, agar aap kuch padh rahe hain, to aap questions ko bhi dekhein, ki aap usi direction mein padh rahe hain. Right? Jaise main aapko batati hu, I never took coaching from any institute. But, maine kya kiya hamesha? Maine bank PO se lekar, कोई भी स्टेट सिविल सर्विसेज के एग्जामिनेशन सारे देती रही मैं साथ में. सो व्हाट वाज द रिजल्ट, उससे मेरा ट्रैक रहा किस तरह के क्वेश्चंस पूछे जा रहे हैं एग्जाम्स में. दैट हैज केप्ट मी अपडेटेड एंड आई क्लियर द एग्जाम. देन यू कैन आल्सो डू, इट्स नॉट लाइक, राइट स्ट्रेटजी इज इम्पोर्टेंट, राइट? सो आप क्वेश्चंस को भी साइमल्टेनियसली पढ़ते रहे कि जो आप पढ़ रहे हैं वो आप सही दिशा में पढ़ रहे हैं, जो क्वेश्चंस वहां पूछे जा रहे हैं आप उसी हिसाब से पढ़ भी रहे हैं. दैट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. तो 10 years, लास्ट 10 years के क्वेश्चन पेपर्स जरूर खरीदे साथ में, राइट? एंड साथ में अपनी प्रिपरेशन को अपडेटेड रखने के लिए साथ में एग्जाम्स भी भरते रहे. लाइक यूपीएससी में तो यू हैव लिमिटेड अटेम्प्ट्स, 6 अटेम्प्ट्स हैं, लेकिन इन स्टेट सिविल सर्विसेज देर आर नो अटेम्प्ट्स. सो बिसाइड्स दैट आप उनको भी दे सकते हैं, सो दैट आपका एक मेंटल एटीट्यूड बना रहे एग्जाम देने को, आप एक बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट समझ सके कि सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन मांग क्या रहा है आपसे, राइट? तो आप इन चीजों को हमेशा ध्यान में रखें. नाउ माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट जनरल स्टडीज पेपर 1, जनरल स्टडीज पेपर 2. ये मैं आपको पहले ही बता चुकी हूँ, प्रीलिम्स का जनरल स्टडी पेपर 2 क्वालिफाइंग है, जनरल स्टडीज का पेपर 1 में आपको स्कोर करना पड़ता है. जैसे मैं आपको अभी बताती हूँ, 2016 में जो मेरिट गया था इनका वो 118 गया था जनरल का मेरिट, राइट? आफ्टर वर्ड इट हैज नेवर क्रॉस्ड अबव 100. लास्ट ईयर इट वाज 98. तो नाउ आई विल डिस्कस हाउ टू अटेम्प्ट जनरल स्टडीज पेपर 1 प्रीलिम्स, राइट? यू हैव टू अडॉप्ट मैक्सिमलिस्ट अप्रोच. लाइक यू हैव टू अटेम्प्ट मैक्सिमम क्वेश्चंस, बट with that, what you have to keep in mind that there is negative marking also in exam, right? Negative marking bhi wahan pe hai. To aapko dhyan rakhna hai ki how to attempt the paper. So what I suggest and what I have ever done, right? Jaise hi aapke haath mein question paper aata hai, go through the exam once, go through the question paper once, right? And the easy questions, the questions which are easy, you have to attempt those, ठीक है? Easy questions से क्या मतलब है? There are direct questions. Now I will tell with questions also that what are direct questions, what are indirect questions. तो direct questions है, आपने अच्छे से अपना preparation किया होगा, आप उसको तुरंत mark कर देंगे, right? Then go second round. Then second round में फिर देखें जो questions आपके बच गए थे, उनमें ध्यान लगाएं. वो कौन से questions होते हैं? Those are analytical questions. Like I'll share questions with you. Like डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चंस एंड इनडायरेक्ट क्वेश्चंस कैसे होते हैं, जो आपको फर्स्ट गो में, फर्स्ट राउंड में एग्जाम्स में मार्क करने हैं. जैसे एक क्वेश्चन है फ्रॉम लास्ट ईयर सिविल सर्विसेज, दैट इज द एक्सपेरिमेंट विल एम्प्लॉय अ ट्रायो ऑफ स्पेसक्राफ्ट फ्लाइंग इन फॉर्मेशन इन द शेप ऑफ एन इक्वेटोरियल ट्रायंगल दैट हैज साइड 1 million किलोमीटर्स लॉन्ग विथ लेजर्स शाइनिंग बिटवीन द क्राफ्ट. द एक्सपेरिमेंट इन द क्वेश्चन रेफर्स टू, अब इसमें हमारे पास ऑप्शंस हैं वॉयजर 2, न्यू होराइजन, यूएसए पाथफाइंडर एंड द लास्ट इज इवॉल्व्ड लीसा. द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज इवॉल्व्ड लीसा. इफ यू हैव रेड न्यूज़पेपर्स प्रॉपरली, इफ यू हैव रेड मैगजीन्स प्रॉपरली, देन यू मस्ट बी नोइंग द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन, राइट? एंड दिस आर द डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन. दीज क्वेश्चन यू कैन टेक इन फर्स्ट गो ओनली, राइट? एंड द अदर क्वेश्चन आई विल डिस्कस इज दोज आर इनडायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन. दे नीड सम थिंकिंग, दे नीड सम टाइम. सो यू हैव टू attempt those questions in second round or third round. Like the question I'll discuss is these type of questions you get. Simple questions, direct questions, indirect questions. ठीक है? The example of indirect question is, I'll just discuss one question with you. That is, consider the following statements. First, genetic changes can be introduced in the cell that produce eggs or sperms of prospective parent. Second, a person's genome can be edited before birth at early embryonic stage. Third, human-induced pluripotent stem cells can be injected into embryo of the pig. So the question is, which of the statements are correct? A option is 1 only, B option is 2 and 3 only, C option is 2 only, and D option is 1, 2, 3. So these type of questions need time to solve, right? So these questions you have to attempt in second or third round, right? After analyzing and after attempting the direct questions, right? So this should be your approach. Like in general studies paper 1, there is negative marking also. Like if you do 3 wrong question, then your 1 correct question will be deducted, right? So, and risk too, you have to take always. Life is all about taking risk, and it always, right? So risk lena padta hai, but that too a smart risk that should give some result to you, right? And my dear friends, jab aap college mein hote hain to sochte hain ki ek attempt de do, 6 attempts to hai, ek attempt se kya farak padega? Never. If you are not prepared, don't waste your attempts ever. If you are fully prepared, only then give your exams, right? UPSC mein, I always told, in the initial stage also told, that there is no space for overconfidence, right? So you have to be very wise while choosing ki attempt kab dena hai, kyunki hum logon ne bhi first attempt aise de diya tha, bahut attempts hai college mein, de dete hai ek, humne kaun sa puri umar preparation karni hai, but nahi. This is a long journey. UPSC ki jo preparation hai na, it will mold you. And it will help you to evolve also in a positive way. I will say this thing. It will help you evolve positively also, right? So you should be very wise in your choices. What to do, what not to do, right? And while marking questions ke answers also, you have to be very wise. Because I told initially, 10 lakh log form bharte hain, 5-6 lakh jo log hain, wo paper dete hain, aur usme se sirf 10,000 log nikalte hain prelims mein. To ab aapko un 10,000 mein jagah banani hai, तो आपको स्मार्ट बनना पड़ेगा अपने आंसर्स चूज करने में, अपने नंबर ऑफ अटेम्प्ट्स आपको कब देने हैं उनको चूज करने में, और आपको वो प्रॉपर एक स्ट्रेटजी बनानी पड़ेगी, राइट? एंड दो शुड बी क्लियर इन योर हेड, राइट? क्योंकि सक्सेस देखो उन्हीं लोगों को मिलती है जो अपने माइंड में क्लियर होते हैं कि उनको चाहिए क्या, ठीक है? दो नाव में सवार होके आप कभी सक्सेस नहीं पा सकते, राइट? एंड as I have discussed earlier, that this is a long journey because exam itself is a tedious thing, exhaustive hai. Ek saal aapko lagega sirf exam dene mein, preparation ko chhod ke. To my dear friends, jise my option was public administration. To preparation karte karte maine MA public administration private kar liya tha correspondence. So usne mujhe kahan help kiya? Usne mujhe interview mein help kiya. Because to crack exam, डेढ़ साल I did nothing, I just prepared, right? तो जब मुझसे इंटरव्यू में पूछा गया कि what you did, because वो आपको घुमाने की कोशिश करेंगे, वो आपको पूछेंगे आपने डेढ़ साल किया क्या, although they also know कि preparation में साथ में कुछ करना बहुत मुश्किल काम है, right? But अगर मैं उनको बता दूं कि मैंने MA public administration साथ में किया है, that would obviously create positive impression, ठीक है? तो साथ में जो कुछ ईजी हो, आपका ऑप्शन हो, तो आप कुछ करते रहिए, because that would always help you in interview also. What would that reflect? That a positive frame के आदमी हैं, आप मेहनत करना चाहते हैं, आपने preparation के साथ देखो एक MA भी कर लिया, आपने preparation के साथ एक diploma course भी कर लिया, तो वो आपको हमेशा help करता है, ठीक है? But ये मेरा suggestion है, सब ऐसा करें ये जरूरी नहीं, और सब ऐसा करते हैं ऐसा भी नहीं होता, ठीक है? तो ये सिर्फ मेरा suggestion है, अगर आप में उतनी zeal है, आप में उतना courage है, तो जरूर करिए, ठीक है? और देखिए जो सिविल सर्विसेज का प्रिपरेशन है, शुरू में आपको बहुत रिजेक्शंस मिलेंगे. पहले देखिए शुरू में क्या होगा, 6 महीने आपके पेरेंट्स, आपकी फैमिली फ्रेंड्स सबको बताएंगे कि हमारा बेटा सिविल सर्विसेज की प्रिपरेशन कर रहा है. बट देखो 6 महीने में इसका ना रिजल्ट आता है ना प्रिपरेशन पूरी होती है, तो आपको टाइम लगता है. तो फिर 6 महीने के बाद वो भी बताना बंद कर देंगे कि रिजल्ट तो कोई आ नहीं रहा. बट आपको डिसहार्टन नहीं होना, यू हैव टू बिलीव इन योर सेल्फ, ठीक है? इस दुनिया में सर्वाइव करने का सबसे अच्छा तरीका क्या है, सबसे अच्छा मंत्र क्या है? सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट, जो चार्ल्स डार्विन पहले ही बोल चुके हैं. आपको अपने पे भरोसा रखना है, ठीक है? आपने अपने आप को फिटेस्ट बनाए रखना है कि लोग जो बोल रहे हैं बोलते रहे, मुझे पता है कि मेरी प्रिपरेशन कैसी चल रही है. तो डोंट बी डिसहार्टेंड, बिकॉज इस एग्जाम में देखो बहुत सारे हैसल्स हैं, सोसाइटी से भी हैसल होते हैं, आप मेंटली भी परेशान होते हैं, आपके पेरेंट्स इतनी उम्मीद लगाए बैठे होते हैं, फैमिली फ्रेंड्स कोई रिजल्ट आएगा तो पूछेंगे अच्छा उस रिजल्ट का क्या हुआ, बल्कि पता उनको होगा वो फिर भी पूछेंगे, लेकिन आपने कभी उस चीज से डिसहार्टेंड नहीं होना. मैं बताती हूँ, 2011 में मेरी बहन की शादी थी और 2010 नवंबर में मैंने प्रिपरेशन स्टार्ट की थी. तो अब 11 नवंबर तक कोई रिजल्ट आ जाए, एक प्री का रिजल्ट आया था राजस्थान का जो मैंने क्लियर कर लिया था, और उसका मेंस मुझे दिसंबर में देना था, तो सब पूछ रहे थे कि अच्छा अच्छा अब तो फ्री बैठे होंगे ना, अब तो कुछ नहीं कर रहे होंगे। तो अब देखो उस चीज का मेरे पास कोई जवाब नहीं था, इनसाइड आई वाज फीलिंग वेरी ह्यूमिलेटेड। लेकिन दोस थिंग्स यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड, एंड आपको हमेशा अपना आप एक स्ट्रॉन्ग हेडेड रहना है, क्योंकि ये एग्जाम एक बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग विलनेस मांगता है, स्ट्रॉन्ग हेडेड आपकी डिटर्मिनेशन मांगता है। सो डोंट बी डिसहार्टेंड विद दीज थिंग्स ऑल्सो, बिकॉज दिस एग्जाम इज अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव एग्जाम जहां आपको सोशली मेंटली हर चीज में अपने आपको फिट रखना है, आपको किसी भी चीज के प्रेशर में नहीं आना है। एंड एंजॉय योर प्रिपरेशन, जब आप अपना प्रिपरेशन स्टार्ट कर रहे हैं तो एंजॉय करें उसको, उस स्टेज को एंजॉय करें। बिकॉज आई टोल्ड ना अपने बारे में कि जैसे मुझे बड़ा मजा आता था, अब जैसे बादल आ रहे हैं, फॉग बन रही है, तो अब मैं ज्योग्राफी में उसको पढ़ती थी, क्योंकि स्कूल टाइम में तो देखो कोई भी इतने कॉन्सेप्ट लगाता नहीं है, ना ही हमारे इंडिया का एजुकेशन सिस्टम ऐसा है कि हमको पता रहे कि ये चीजें क्यों हो रही हैं। तब तो हमें पढ़ने के लिए एग्जाम लिख देते थे स्कूल में, अब जब पढ़ने लगे, अब एनालाइज करने लगे यूपीएससी में, तो बड़ा मजा आता था कि पता होता है अच्छा ये इस तरह के क्लाउड इसको बोलते हैं, आसमान में अगर बन रहा है तो नॉर्थ पोल, अच्छा ये ऐसे होता है। तो स्टार्ट एंजॉइंग योर प्रिपरेशन, और बहुत अच्छे से उसको आप करें विद पॉजिटिव फ्रेम ऑफ माइंड। और जहां तक मैं सोचती हूँ, इफ यू डू एनी वर्क विद पॉजिटिव फ्रेम ऑफ माइंड विद पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड, रिजल्ट आपको जरूर मिलते हैं, ठीक है। तो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, एज इट वाज अ सेशन ऑफ वन आवर ओनली, तो इसमें मैं आपको जनरल स्टडीज प्रीलिम्स का ही बता पाई हूँ। फॉर फर्दर आप अभी अपने प्रिपरेशन स्टार्ट कीजिए, एंड आई विल शेयर माय नंबर आल्सो, एंड फॉर मेंस वी विल डिस्कस इन अदर सेशन, राइट, बिकॉज फॉर वन आवर में इतना पॉसिबल नहीं है डिस्कस करना। बट जो मैंने आपको बुक्स बताई, आप अगर डिटर्मिन है टू प्रिपेयर, देन आप उन बुक्स को जरूर खरीदिए एंड स्टार्ट प्रिपेयरिंग, because I think you all are doing your graduation, so आप जो है वो अभी से इसको start करिए, newspaper reading का habit डालिए, magazines पढ़िए, basic books पढ़िए, और अपने आप को updated रखिए, right? And in the end मैं आपको बताना चाहूंगी, never be disheartened, my dear friends, दो lines आपके साथ share करना चाहती हूँ। Everyone has a story to tell, some now, while others in time to come. तो हो सकता है आज मेरा टाइम है, कल आपका टाइम होगा। सो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई विल एंड द सेशन हियर ओनली, एंड इफ देयर आर एनी क्वेश्चंस यू कैन आस्क मी हियर। थैंक यू।
ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो द हाउस इज ओपन फॉर द क्वेश्चंस नाउ, सो इन केस यू हैव एनी क्वेरी, यू वांट टू आस्क समथिंग, फील फ्री, यू कैन ईदर अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड आस्क द क्वेश्चन, और यू कैन राइट इन द चैट बॉक्स।
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम।
यस
मैम, आपने कहा कि आपने साथ में पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन कर ली थी, तो आई वांट टू आस्क दिस इज मैंडेटरी, और कि अगर हम बीकॉम जैसे ऑनर्स कर रहे हैं, बीकॉम ऑनर्स के बाद अगर हम सिविल एग्जाम के तरफ जाते हैं, तो उनको ये बताना जरूरी होगा कि हमने कुछ नहीं किया साथ?
नहीं, दिस वॉज माई सजेशन, इट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट। बहुत सारे लोग सिर्फ प्रिपरेशन करते हैं, एंड इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट इट विल इम्पैक्ट योर इंटरव्यू, नो नॉट एट ऑल, इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट। इट वॉज माई सजेशन, लाइक जैसे इट इज माई हैबिट दैट इफ आई कीप ऑन डूइंग समथिंग दैट कीप मी यू नो कॉन्फिडेंट, दैट कीप मी हैप्पी, तो इट्स आपका जनरल है आपका, अगर आप करना चाहें तो ठीक है, नहीं तो बहुत सारे लोग नहीं भी करते, ऐसा नहीं है, इट्स नॉट मैंडेटरी, राइट। लेकिन लाइक आई वॉन्ट टू गिव एग्जाम्पल, सपोज आप इंटरव्यू ले रही हैं, एंड आपके सामने कोई आता है और आपको बोलता है, बिकॉज एज आई टोल्ड ना, द एग्जाम इज अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस, लाइक वन ईयर तो इसको एग्जाम देने में ही लगता है। तो आप मान लो एक इंटरव्यू में बैठी हैं, और आप किसी का इंटरव्यू ले रही है, एंड दैट पर्सन सेज कि 3 ईयर से मैं सिर्फ प्रिपरेशन कर रहा हूँ, एंड अदर कैंडिडेट आपके पास आता है और वो बोलता है कि मैं 4 ईयर से प्रिपरेशन कर रहा हूँ, लेकिन मैंने साथ में ये कोर्सेज परस्यू कर लिए, तो आपका पॉजिटिव इम्प्रेशन किसके लिए रहेगा? उसी के लिए ना जो बोलेगा, तो आप लोगों बोलोगे कि नहीं यार ये ज्यादा विजनरी लग रहा है, सिर्फ इतना सा इम्पैक्ट होता है, इट्स ऑल अबाउट इम्प्रेशन, नथिंग एल्स। राइट. एंड जैसे मैंने बताया कि मैंने पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन में किया है, तो उसके लिए मुझे कोई एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट्स नहीं करने पड़े. इट वॉज माई ऑप्शनल सब्जेक्ट, तो आई जस्ट गेव एमए बिकॉज मुझे कुछ पढ़ना ही नहीं पड़ता था उसमें, बिकॉज आई ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर सिविल सर्विसेज, वो भी मेन्स में अगर मेरा ऑप्शनल था पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, तो दैट वॉज हेल्पफुल. मुझे उसमें कोई एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट्स नहीं करने पड़े. इट्स ऑल ऑप्शनल, इट्स नॉट लाइक इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट.
Ma'am, another student is asking that if someone is interested in taking up civil services, then how to manage along with graduation?
As I have given you example of Tina Darby, she used to study in Khan Coaching Center, right? तो वो क्या करते थे, जैसे बहुत सारे कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट में ऐसा होता है कि उन्होंने जो है वो वीकेंड्स के सेशंस रखे होते हैं जो लोग कॉलेज जाते हैं, तो वीकेंड्स में दे यूज टू प्रिपेयर, सैटरडे संडे वो वहां लगाएंगे. And then they prepare alongside with graduation. Because देखो life में अगर हम कुछ करना चाहते हैं तो time हमेशा होता है. जो ऐसा बोलते हैं time नहीं होता वो गलत बोलते हैं, ऐसा नहीं होता. अब देखो Saturday Sunday अगर मान लो मैं school या college जा रही हूँ या मैं office भी जा रही हूँ, तो मैं चाहे पूरा दिन movie देखने में waste कर दूँ, पूरा दिन चाहे mauling में waste कर दूँ, पूरा दिन चाहे friends के साथ waste कर दूँ, वो मैं बोलूँगी कि मेरा leisure time है. But वही time अगर मैं कंटिन्यूसली स्टडीज में डिवोट करूंगी तो स्टडीज के लिए भी मिल जाएंगे. इट्स नॉट लाइक कि आपको बहुत सीरियसली पढ़ना है. आप ग्रेजुएशन में साथ साथ में न्यूज़पेपर पढ़िए, बेसिक्स बुक्स पढ़िए, और अपनी ग्रेजुएशन कंप्लीट करने के बाद आप फुल टाइम फिर उसमें करिए. जब आपके बेसिक्स क्लियर होंगे देन आफ्टर ग्रेजुएशन आपको उतना हार्डवर्क पुट नहीं करना पड़ेगा. जैसे वन ईयर हमको तो बहुत हार्डवर्क पुट इन करना पड़ेगा, ग्रेजुएशन तक हमने कुछ किया ही नहीं. साइड बाय साइड रख सकते हैं. देखिए इतना आप भी जानते हैं, हम भी जानते हैं, जैम टाइम्स के बिना ग्रेजुएशन में भी रोज का एक दो घंटा तो आराम से निकलता ही निकलता है. अगर आपको करना है कुछ तो आप एक दो घंटे वोट करिए. एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस?
Yes, students, any other question from your side? I guess there are no more questions, ma'am. Thank you so much for such an informative session.
Oh, no, it was my pleasure to, you know, to help people in this way, because I always wanted to help people. So they can reach me also if they want any help. But I will say that you should be determined. If you are serious, then you have to prepare and never sail through two boats. Because it is always dangerous to sail in two boats. Be determined. अगर आप मन बना चुके हैं कि preparation करना है, then do the preparation without thinking results, right? And I am always there to help you. You can contact me anytime.
Thank you so much. Students are saying that the session was really informative, and they have acquired a good pool of knowledge about how to start preparing for the general studies paper. Thank you, ma'am, for sharing your experience and your journey with us. Thank you so much. Thank you, Itendra sir, for organizing the session. Thank you, Shikha ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
थैंक यू शिखा जी.
इंद्र जी, टू अलाउ मी टू स्पीक ऑन दिस फोरम, इट वाज रियली रियली गुड.
थैंक यू लिसनर्स फॉर बीइंग द पेशेंट लिसनर्स, एंड थैंक यू मैम एंड थैंक यू सर. Hope to have such good sessions in the near future as well. Thank you so much.